got to be one of the most annoying of all problems around the house, the creaky staircase. And when you see just how easy it is to repair, you'll be wondering why you didn't tackle it years ago. I'm also going to be looking at installing a new fireplace and shutters. Are they a good way to update your home both inside and out? But first, do you have the right tools to do those jobs around the house? Having the right tools in your toolkit makes life an awful lot easier when it comes to getting down to those DIY jobs. But with literally hundreds of tools available, where do you start? So here's a couple of good guidelines. Probably one of the most important things is you only buy the tools that you need to do that job, because the tool collection is built over time, job by job. Number two is buy the best quality tools you can. If you look after them, they last a lifetime and make doing jobs an awful lot easier. But stay away from cheap toolkits that claim to have every tool you'll ever need. You rarely get good quality tools. It's a false economy. So here are six of the most essential tools to start off any good toolkit. The first is your screw gun, or battery operated drill, and a set of bits. You'll often get the bits with the drill. And the best way to go is to go with a mid-priced one. The more expensive ones are generally for everyday use, and the cheap ones are rubbish. It's a very handy machine. It'll take an awful lot of labour out of using a screwdriver. Or if you end up with a bent screw stuck in a wall, which you'll never be able to undo by hand, the trick is take the bit out of the gun. You open up the jaws at the top. And if you have a screw, which you can't unscrew by hand because it's after getting bent like that, then all you do is close the gun on top of the screw and then stick it on reverse and it'll take out the bent old screw. Now, the second most essential of tools is your hammer. There's a couple of basic rules to go with a hammer. This one is a claw hammer, and again, it's the most versatile of them all. One of the first things you must remember is never go past 16 ounces with a hammer and never go under 12 ounces. The whole idea is that you get the hammer to do the work. Now, the third one is a combination pliers. It's a great tool and it's very, very versatile. It does the same job as many pliers, except all in one. It can be used for the likes of shortening a screw with the snips on it, like that, with the sharp piece here. It can be used for tightening things with the tight teeth in it for turning around. And it can be used for stripping open wires. So there you go, a combination pliers is a very useful and very versatile tool. The next one we have is an electrical phase tester, also called a mains tester. It's great to use as either a slot head screwdriver for putting on a plug top, opening up a socket, or doing any electrical work with. But the best thing about it is, if you come across a wire underneath the press or somewhere else in the house, and you're not sure if it's live or not, all you do is you put the top of the screwdriver onto the top of the wire, put your finger on the top, and if there's electricity in that wire, it'll light up in the center. Now the next one has to be a spirit level. It's probably just one of the most important of all tools, and there's no point in getting the little small ones because they lose their accuracy over any kind of a distance. So either go for a mid-level one or a long one. They're also used as a good straight edge for just marking a straight line or for cutting a length of plasterboard with a knife across the side of it. It's a very important one though. You can't do any job without it, from curtain poles to shelves. Now, last but not least, and probably the very most important, is safety gear. At the end of the day, doing a bit of DIY isn't worth losing your eye over. Top six tools, screw gun. Number two, no job can be done without it, spirit level. Number three, a combination plier. Number four, a claw hammer. Number five, an electrical phase tester. And last, but probably most important, is your safety gear.